Aloha everyone, my name is Nani Moraoka, and today I will be doing an extension activity on the pat mat for age group 5.5 months to 8 months. So the name of my extension is called Aquamat. The activity calls for a Ziploc bag, a gallon size, preferably with the zipper and not the slider, because these leak a lot less. You'll need some water. And then I just found some things around the house that you can use things every day. And then these are good also because you help your child play and learn with things that you have. So everyday items. So I have things like sponges, straws. These are some pen caps that I just cut the part that sticks to your pocket. Just everyday things, cut up some straws. If you have foam, you can cut up foam pieces and shapes. If you don't have foam, you could always use styrofoam from like meats when you go grocery shopping and cut them yourself. So to get started, you just get your bag and you can double it. If you notice that your baby is very aggressive with their hands or like to dig into things, you can double the bag, but for today I'm just using one. So you fill up the bag about a third full. It's about there. If you wanna go a little more, that's fine. But so when you do the bag, you'll have to hold it because your baby might, you know, spill it. And then allow your baby to grab the items and drop them in. And while your baby's dropping the items, just kinda name them. So like sponge, straw. Oh, the sponge and the straw is pink. They match in colors. So even though your baby isn't speaking yet, they're learning language, learning just to bond with you and be involved in the activity. So, you know, again, let them drop however much they want. If they grab everything at once, it's okay. So just kind of follow your baby's lead in play. If they don't want to put everything, if they just want to put one, fine. If they don't want to put anything, that's fine too. So I also have things like paper clips. The paper clips actually sink. So you can find things that float and sink, and you can talk about that too. Buoyancy and things like that, introducing new words and language. So that goes there. So I'll just put a few. And then what you want to do is, after you fill the bag, you want to squeeze as much air out as possible just so that the things are able to float. If you can leave some air, that's great too. So once you seal the bag, you can use duct tape or clear packing tape. I like to use clear packing tape just because it shows the whole bag as your baby is playing. So this is just to prevent accidents and spills while your baby is smashing the bag and poking at it. So just make sure it's sealed. And then, so I have a tray here. If you don't have a tray at home like this, you could always cut a piece of cardboard from a box. As long as it's something you can tape the product to. If you want, you could even just tape it to your table. That would be good also, as long as it can be set in place, just so your baby doesn't lift it and, you know, throw it and things like that. So I'll just put a little bit tape on both sides. If you want, you can do all four sides. So this is what the finished product will look like. Some things are floating. Notice the bigger items, they kind of just sit to the bottom just because there's not enough water. So if you do want everything to float, you can add more water than what I did. I wouldn't recommend going more than half just because it can get really heavy and the bag can open. Just encourage your baby to play and touch the bag, touch the items. Oh, notice the paper clips are on the bottom. They sank. Why do you think they don't float? And of course, your baby won't answer you, but you can answer for your baby. But if not, you can just encourage your baby to press on the different items. This one is soft and squishy, and this one is hard. So focusing on different words that you can use with your baby. You can name colors. So what colors do we have? We have yellow. And point to each of the objects as you're talking about them, and not just be like, oh, there's a purple cover or an orange paper clip, because your baby won't know what you're talking. So you want to make, allow your baby to make connections with hearing pink often or blue often and noticing the colors. Eventually, as they get older, they'll make the connection. That's blue, that's green. And that's how you can teach language development from very early on, before they even talk. So these types of activities allow for cognitive development, social emotional development, language, and also gross motor and fine motor. So they're learning all of these things. And if you make it a fun and safe environment, your baby will tend to play a lot more, explore a lot more, and feel comfortable. So taking good risks, right? That's what we wanna do. These things outside of the packaging, not a great idea for your baby to play with. But in this type of activities, it's a great way for them to learn and feel these types of objects, because we know at this age, everything will go in their mouth. So keeping it in the bag and in something like this will definitely be safe for them also. At this age, everything is new. You know, they want to try different things. And if they feel safe and comfortable with you playing and encouraging them to try new things in a safe environment, they'll feel more attached to you. They'll play better, play longer. And then it really kind of keeps them engaged for a lot longer. Okay, so that's the activity extension for PatMat. Which we named Aquamat as part of our superpowers, bringing out your superpowers as a parent and caregiver. So thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of our presentation.